be 1 upon 2, so this is 1 by 2 plus x minus 1, fx of 1, 2 is minus 1 by 2 plus y minus 2, fy of 1, 2 was minus 1 by 4 plus 1 upon 2 factorial x minus 1 whole square fx sx was 1 plus 2 into x minus 1 y minus 2 fx y of 1 2 will be 1 upon 4, so this is 1 by 4 plus y minus 2 whole square f y y of 1 2 is okay, sorry I remember to find f of y by 2, let us try to find f of y by 2. Fyy is equal to Fyy of 1 comma 2 is 2 upon 1 into 2 cube, this is 1 by 4. Fyy of 1 upon 2 is 1 by 4. Replace this value, this is 1 by 4. So this is the Taylor series expansion of this function f of xy is equal to 1 upon xy in the power of x minus 1 and y minus 2. Okay. Let us see one more example. Calculate the under root 17 into cube root of 7 approximately using Taylor series expansion up to first order term. We have to apply Taylor series up to first order terms. Okay, let us try to solve this example. Consider f of xy is equal to under root x into third root of y. Okay. So now we have to apply Taylor series up to first order term, that means we have to find only fx and fy. So fx of xy is equal to differentiation of partial derivatives of this function with respect to x. So 1 upon 2 root x into this will constant, so it will remains as it is, and fy of xy is equal to under root x into derivatives of this term with respect to y. This is 1 upon 3 y raised to minus 2 by 3. Okay. Now we have to use this alternating form of Taylor series. Okay. Set please. We have to use this form f of a plus h b plus k of alternated form of Taylor series. Okay. Table talk please. F of a plus h b plus k is equal to f of a b plus h into fx of a b plus k into fy of a b plus up to so on, but we have to apply up to first order term, so we have to stop here. Okay, so f of a plus h b plus k will be under root of a plus h, because this is our function f of xy is equal to under root x into cube root of y, so this will becomes b plus k raised to 1 by 3. This is f of a b, that means root of a into cube root of b plus h fx of a b. From here fx of a b, if you replace x is equal to a, y is equal to b, then this will becomes 1 upon 2 root a into b raised to 1 by 3 plus k into, here apply fy of ab, this is fy of xy, but we have to find fy of ab, so replace x is equal to a and y is equal to b, so this will becomes root a into 1 upon 3 y b raised to minus 2 by 3. Okay, now see here, we have to find value of this function. This can be written in this form, 16 plus 1, and this can be written into 8 minus 1 raised to 3. Why we choose 16 and 8? Because we have to find under root a and cube root of b. So we have to find nearest integer, nearest positive integer whose square root is possible. So nearest perfect square is 16 from 17, it is 16, and nearest positive integer whose cube root is possible from 7 is 8. Cube root of 8 is possible and square root of 16 is possible. So we choose 16 and 8. Okay. So take A is equal to 16 and B is equal to 8. So under root A plus and H is equal to 1 and K is equal to minus 1. So A plus H is equal to 16 plus 1, that means 17. And B plus K, that means 8 minus 1, this is 7 cube, is equal to under root A, that means under root 16, into cube root of B. Cube root of B is 8, plus H is equal to 1, into 1 upon 2 under root A is equal to 16, into cube root of B, this is B, plus K is equal to minus 1. This is 1 by 3 is already there, into under root A, this is under root 16, and B raised to minus 2 by 3. Okay. So square root of 16 is 4 and cube root of 8 is 2, plus 1 is 1 upon 2 into square root of 16 is again 4, this is 2, minus 1 upon 3, this is 4. 8 raised to 1 by 3 is 2. 2 raised to minus 2 is 1 by 4. This is 1 by 4. So this is 8 plus 2, 2 will cancel. This is 1 by 4 minus this is 1 by 3. 4, 4 will cancel. This is 1 by 3. So is equal to 8 plus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3. LCM is 12. 96 plus 3. Minus 4, this is 95 by 12, this is approximately 7.91666. okay, so this is the approximate value of this value. Okay. So using this is the use of Taylor series. Using Taylor series, we can find the approximate value of some function like this. Now third example is, we have to find Taylor series at origin of this function e raised to x plus y. That means Taylor series at origin, it is Maclaurin series. That means we have to find the Maclaurin series of this function f of x is equal to e raised to x plus y. That means we have to consider AB is equal to 0 comma 0. Okay. Now f of x is equal to e raised to x plus y implies f of xy is equal to e raised to x plus y implies f of 0, 0 is equal to e raised to 0 plus 0, this is e raised to 0, 1, fx of xy is equal to e raised to x plus y, because e raised to y is constant and differentiation of e raised to x with respect to e raised to x is e raised to x, implies fx of 0, 0 is again e raised to 0, 1, fy of xy is equal to same things, because in this case e raised to x will be constant and differentiation of e raised to y with respect to e raised to y is e raised to y. So this is e raised to x plus y implies fy of 0, 0 is 1. Proceeding in this way, all the differentiation with respect to x and y will be 1. So now we have f of xy is equal to Maclaurin series of any function f of xy is f of 0 comma 0 plus x into fx of 0 comma 0 plus y into fy of 0 comma 0 plus 1 upon 2 factorial fxx of 0 comma 0, here is x square, plus 2xy fxy of 0,0 plus y square of fyy of 0,0 plus up to so on. But we know that all the partial derivatives at x is equal to 0,0 will be 1. So Maclaurin series expansion will be f of 0,0 is 1 plus x into 1 plus y into fy of 0,0 is 1. So this is y into 1 plus 1 upon 2 factorial x square into fx x of 0,0 is x square into fx x of 0,0 is 1 plus 2xy fxy of 0,0 is 1 plus y square fyy of 0,0 is 1 plus up to so on. So this is Maclaurin series expansion of areas to x plus y. It is also known as Taylor series at origin. Now let us try to find Maclaurin series expansion of areas to x into cos y. Next example is in the same case, in the case we have to consider AB is equal to 0,0 because we have to find Maclaurin series of this function. That means we have to find Taylor series at origin. That's why we have to consider center at 0,0. Now here function is f of xy is e raised to x into cos y, implies f of 0,0 is e raised to 0 into cos 0. Cos 0 is 1, e raised to 0 is 1. So this is 1. Now find x f x of xy. Differentiation of e raised to x with respect to x is e raised to x. Cos x is constant because we have to differentiate with respect to x. Implies f of 0,0 is e raised to 0. This is into cos 0 is 1. Now find f x of xy. This is same thing, e raised to x into cos y, implies f of 0,0 is 1. Now let us try to find f y of x y. Differentiation of this function with respect to y. E raised to x is constant because we have to differentiate with respect to y. And differentiation of cos x is cos y is minus sine y, implies f y of 0,0 is 0 because sine 0 is 0, sine 0, 0 into e raised to x is 0. So fy of 0,0 is 0. Now find fyy of xy, where fy is minus e raised to x into sine y. So fyy of xy, that means differentiation of this term with respect to y. This is e raised to minus e raised to x, and this is constant. And differentiation of sine x is with sine y with respect to y is cos y, implies f y y of 0,0 is e raised to 0, 1, cos 0, 1. So this is minus 1. And f x y of x y, f x is equal to e raised to x cos y. So now we have to differentiate this term with respect to y. So this will become minus e raised to x sine y. So f x y of 0,0 is equal to e raised to 0, sine 0 is 0, so this will become 0. So Maclaurin series of e raised to x into cos y is given by e raised to x into cos y is equal to f of 0,0, f of 0,0, that means 1, plus x into fx of 0,0. fxx of 0,0 is, fx of 0,0 is 1, so this is 1, plus y into fy of 0,0, this is 0, plus 1 upon 2 factorial x square fx x of 0,0, this is 1, plus 2xy into fxy of 0,0, this is 0, plus y square into fyy of 0, 0, this is minus 1. So this is 1 plus x plus y plus x square by 2 factorial, this will 0, this is minus y square by 2 factorial. This is 1 plus x plus y plus x square minus y square by 2 factorial plus up to so on. So this is the Maclaurin series of this function e raised to x into cos y. Okay. So here I complete this topics expansion of series. Thank you all of you for your kind attention.